you're down and trouble, and you need some love and care, and nothing, Lord, nothing is going right. Close your eyes and think of me, and soon I will be there to brighten up even your darkest night. You just call out my name, and you know wherever I am, I'll come running to see you again. Winter, spring, summer, or fall, say now all you've got to do is call, and I will be there, yes, I'll be there. You've got a friend. If the sky high above you should turn dark and full of clouds, and that old north wind should begin to blow, keep your poor head together now and call my name out loud now. Soon I'll be knocking upon your door. You just call out my name, and you know wherever I am, I'll come running to see you again. Winter, spring, summer, or fall, say now all you got to do is call, and I will be there, yes, I'll be there. You've got, ain't it good to know that you've got a friend? And people can be so cold, and they'll hurt you and desert you, well, they'll take your soul if you let them. Oh yeah, but don't you let them. You just call out my name, and you know wherever I am, I'll come running to see you again. Winter, spring, summer, or fall, yeah, and all you've got to do is call, and I will be there, yes, I'll be there. You've got a friend. You've got a friend, yeah. Ain't it good to know you've got a friend? Ain't it good to know you've got a friend? I say everybody here tonight, no matter how low you may go sometime, you can take some consolation in one thing. Ain't it good to know? Yeah, yeah, yeah. You've got a friend.
And now the precious presence of Spirit, which brought us into being, fills us. with hope, with possibility. As we gather here in this sacred sanctuary, we understand that it is the presence within that guides us, directs us, inspires us to be and to become the greatest expression of life that we were intended to be. And so we know that this is sacred ground where we stand and where we sit. And we know that the infinite presence of love and wisdom are filling all the presenters, the musicians, everyone who is making this evening a wonderful experience for all of us. And we give thanks for our opportunity to gather heart to heart, mind to mind, to see one another. And those who are here with us on Sunday morning that are actually experiencing at that time the beautiful live stream that will take place. All of us, those physically present and those gathered all around the world, as indeed they are filled with the Spirit. And God is absolutely in this place, encouraging, inspiring, and motivating us to remember who we are, to remember who our beloved brothers and sisters are. And so we come with open hearts and open minds, rejoicing and giving thanks that something wonderful is already ready to emerge. And thankfully, we accept the truth of these words as gratefully and confidently release them to the perfect law of mind, knowing it is complete. And I invite you to join with me in saying, and so it is. Welcome, everyone. Delighted to see you. Happy that we are gathering here and that our wonderful Ray started us out with a great song. And so I'm grateful that wherever you are, and I'm speaking also to our Sunday morning people who will hear this and see this on Sunday morning, you are welcome here. No matter what your spiritual journey may have been up to this moment, be with us during this time. Let us just hold you in love because we love you already. And give thanks, I give thanks, that something wonderful is ready to emerge for all of us. We have spiritual tools that we provide for human experiences, and they're prayer, meditation, spiritual mind treatment, gathering, being together, loving each other through the good times and through the tough times. That's what a beloved community is about. And so you're welcome here. This is an inclusive center. We honor all faith traditions. We honor your particular path, and we love being on this journey together with you. We belong to a larger worldwide organization, the Centers for Spiritual Living. And the Centers for Spiritual Living have been around for about 100 years now. And we have the opportunity to share with each other. Our ministers meet together. We meet together online. We have opportunities to bring this teaching, this beautiful, sane, glorious, wonderful teaching to our greater community, to the world itself. And there is a purpose statement that the Centers for Spiritual Living developed many years ago. And it goes like this. I welcome you to say it with me if you'd like. Awakening humanity to its spiritual magnificence. We are in the process of awakening ourselves to the precious spirit within us. We are in the process of helping each other become aware of this divine presence that is within each and every one of us, all sentient beings. And what a joyous responsibility it is for us to awaken and then for us to help other people wake up to that truth as well. And then the mission is, and will you say it with me, a world that works for everyone. A world that works for all. So we do expand this wonderful statement to include all sentient beings and the earth itself and all the beings there. And of course, as I said, We provide spiritual tools for personal and global transformation. We have that wonderful opportunity to make a difference in our own lives by using these beautiful tools, and to make a difference in our greater community, eventually in the world itself. It's all energy. We're all in the process of sending out the highest vibrations that we possibly can. And here in our center, we have our own statement of purpose, and it goes like this. Join with me if you will. Living, loving, learning, spirituality that works. And so you are most welcome. You want to start coming up? You're most welcome here. We're so glad that this is an opportunity for us to be together physically, as we are always together in our hearts. And about 100 years ago, I thought you could use that. About 100 years ago, Ernest Holmes he's our founder, and he was asked, what are you teaching? What is religious science? What is science of mind? And so he put together what he called What We Believe to help people understand basically what we're about. And so each Thursday night, we like to take one of these, what we call now the Declaration of Principles, and we'd love to have Reverend Mike come up and tell us about it. There you are.
Well, thank you. It's good to see you. Something I haven't seen for a while. Declaration number 10 is, we believe that the universal spirit, which is God, operates through a universal mind, which is the law of God. And we are surrounded by this creative mind, which receives the direct impress of our thoughts and acts upon it. Which is another way of saying, as you believe, so it is done unto you. Sometimes people get upset and think that we want to blame them because they're in a condition that they don't want to be in. And we recognize consciousness has something to do with every condition we're in. What's good is to recognize that if we're in a situation, we don't have to stay in that situation. And by changing our vision, by changing our thoughts, we can create our experience. Another way to say that is, where focus goes, power flows. Power flows where focus goes. One other thing. Sometimes we rely too much upon our own plans, ideas, and thoughts. We think we got it all controlled. Or our mom's dead. Somebody, we got it all mapped out. And what I would suggest we do is do two things. Remember Ray's song that said, remember you got a friend? You do. That's the presence of God. God's presence is your friend, always and always, in all ways. And when we ask that divine presence to guide us, to direct us, it does. It does. Comes up with wonderful little things that when I do that, I had no idea. New comprehension, new ideas. Point is, we don't have to figure it all out ourselves, gang. That divine presence can provide us with the vision we need. Thank you.
Thank you. And next week, which happens to be Halloween, Reverend Mike will be actually doing the service. So you get to hear him on Halloween night.
Isn't that scary?
I don't think so. Okay, good. Thank you. We have a wonderful new opening song that Ray will teach us so easily. It's a lovely song. And I'm going to ask you if you would be comfortable doing so, to stand while he teaches us to sing it, and we just sing it, okay? Our thoughts are prayers.
Our
Our thoughts are prayers, and we are always praying. Our thoughts are prayers. Be aware of what you're saying. Keep a higher consciousness of grace and happiness, and know that God is always there. And every thought remains a prayer. Our thoughts are prayers, and we are always praying. Our thoughts are prayers. Be aware of what you're saying. Keep a higher consciousness of grace and happiness, and know God is always there. And every thought remains a prayer. Okay, one more time. Our thoughts are prayers, and we are always praying. Our thoughts are prayers. Be aware of what you're saying. Keep a higher consciousness of grace and happiness, and know God is always there. And every thought remains a prayer. And every thought remains a prayer.
Do you love it? Nice. Thank you so much. Okay, where's Myla? You are once again representing all of the kids in the world. I mean, that's a big responsibility, but you happen to be the one here. Hi. Okay, have you ever looked through a microscope? Well, what do you see? Come up here and tell me about it, if you don't mind. When you look through a microscope, what are you likely to see? Something. Tell everybody up here. Thank you, sweetie, for coming up. What do you see?
Something that's small, that's big.
Something that's small, not big. Very good. Now, what happens when you look through a telescope? Have you ever looked through a telescope?
I don't think so, no.
Have you ever been to a planetarium? Well, then, what did you see?
The stars.
Yeah, something big, not small. Okay, so we can look at a small view, we can look at a large view, we have that choice that we get to make. You know, one of the things that I always love to do if I'm at a beach that has tide pools, have you ever looked in a tide pool? Well, it's where the rocks gather a little, they contain a little bit of seawater, and it kind of stays there. And what happens is amazing. All of these, there's a whole community. Like everybody has a job. There's these tiny little fish swimming, or teeny, you can barely see them. You have to watch and really look. And you see them going to work, and they're going home again and fixing dinner, and you know, all the things that these little, it's just a little community, you know? And it's fascinating. If you sit very patiently, you begin to see this whole world. There's a whole world, like there's a whole world in a dewdrop. And then if you look through something large, like a telescope, or if you're at a planetarium, you're gonna see the enormity of space. And so the idea here is we have a choice of looking really small, which can be interesting, fascinating. Look through the microscope and see these little tiny beings. There's life everywhere. But then if we're in a place where we're feeling kind of small and kind of constricted, I don't mean small like you are, because you're a small person with a huge beingness. But if we're feeling like we're kind of stuck in something, maybe we have a little problem with somebody at school or something like that, then we have a choice of staying looking small or thinking bigger, remembering that God lives right within us And as soon as I come back to that place, I can see the people that I might have had a fuss with as the beautiful beings they are. I can see the situation like, oh, let's see, I have a paper due tomorrow. I better start it right away. Ever had? No, you wouldn't do that. But I could gather my internal resources and ask Spirit within me to give me the divine download that I need to get that done. It's a matter of getting a bigger picture. You know what I mean? You have an idea about what it would be like to have a challenge that makes you feel kind of limited and then getting a bigger picture? What might that be? Any thoughts?
I don't know. I just listened to what you just said.
I know, but you'll be thinking about it this week, won't you? I love you. Thank you. Thanks for coming up. Yay, my love. Oh. Yeah, human problems are always small, really. They feel big, but they're always small. And the divine solutions are always infinite. That's the thing we didn't remember. Okay, I'm so excited. Our newest board member is now going to come up and for the first time tell you the announcements. Yay, Linda. Linda Solomons.
Hi. My name is Linda Solomons, and we have a very exciting opportunity to get together for an interfaith prayer vigil before the election. This is going to be held at St. Francis of the Fields Episcopal Church, and it's going to be Sunday, November 3rd at 4 p.m. You don't have to register. You can just show up. And this church is located at 689 Sugartown Road in Malvern. So come and let's have a peaceful gathering and pray for unity. So the next night, on Monday evening, November 4th, will be our Nibbles and New Thought, which is held every first Monday of the month. It starts at 6:30. It's at TJ's in Paoli, and we do ask that you register just so we have enough chairs in the restaurant. We always have fun. So the next one is talking about our Thanksgiving celebration. It's actually going to be held Wednesday night instead of Thanksgiving Day, right here, and starting at 6:30. So celebration of gratitude will be here, and then at 7:15, we're going to move over to the fellowship hall for lots of food and goodies. So you don't have to bring a dish, but if you want to, please register online, drop down. There's a little drop down, click on the box, or you can call me personally. I'm going to keep track of the food just so we don't get 10 pumpkin pies and no food. And my phone number is 484-995-2382. Or you could register online. And then the final announcement is to donate still to the CSL Asheville. They still need help. We do have a little box out at the gathering place here. You can do it online. They're still trying to recuperate from the hurricane. Thank you.
Nice job. Thank you. Okay.
Live in love and live in joy. Open up your heart where there is no ending and where there is no start. Go beyond this way or that until the farthest shore. Let go of envy, greed, and pride, and step outside your door. Everything you show is shown to you, too. Easy to see your brother's faults, so hard to face your own. dwelling on your brother's faults just multiplies your own. Everything you do comes back to you. Everything you do.
Let's take a deep, holy breath of spirit. Let that chi, the prana, the very life of life itself flow gently and powerfully through your body, relaxing it, through your emotions, balancing them, through your mind, calming it. Continue to breathe deeply that precious sacred spirit itself and feel it continuing to circulate so beautifully throughout your entire consciousness. The breath is the holy connection. It's that which returns us to the awareness of our source. So let that breath now become a pathway to your heart. Enter in and feel the love, the warm embrace of the divine. Experience the peace, the serenity, where nothing in the outside world can enter here. Rather, spirit is bubbling up. It is the source, the resource. The living waters of spirit are quenching our thirst for God right here within our own being and connecting us with one another. Where there is only one, in this unity, all things become possible, and we rest, and we allow spirit to continue to embrace us lovingly. And now, in this place of peace and power, love, compassion, and truth, let's look out at our world through the eyes of love, the eyes of God, and see as God sees, that all appearances are simply interesting expressions of creativity, and that the truth is what we now behold. And here we have the opportunity to expand any notion that may have felt too small, any idea, any vision that wasn't great enough, and allow spirit to do its wonderful work within us so that we begin to see peace in the world, love and compassion exchanged between all brothers and sisters, a sense of serenity, a deepening faith, a larger view. It is spirit opening our hearts and our minds to feel and to know and to experience a greater reality. And this is where it begins. How grateful we are to know that all is well all is well, truly, truly all is well.
Live in love and live in joy and open up your heart where there is no ending and where there is no star. Everything you do comes back to you. Everything.
Now I would like to invite our practitioner of the evening, Georgiana Gord, to come forward. Thank you.
Thank you. Good. Hello, everybody. Yeah. Dr. Maxine is talking about the better vision, the greater vision, and the bigger picture. And I'm drawn to a quote by Thich Nhat Hanh. Many of you may know who he is. He has really inspired countless people to practice mindfulness and being present, right? And he has a book. His book is called The Art of Power, and there's a quote that is really parallel to what we're talking about tonight and on Sunday morning when you listen. And he says this, "When you look at the sky, you see the clouds and the blue sky at the same time." So when you look at the sky, you see the clouds and the blue sky at the same time. And then he says, vision is like that. It is about holding both the blue sky and the clouds. And if you think about the vision, that even the vision beyond that, beyond the blue sky and beyond the clouds, and how wonderful it is to know and how freeing just to know that there's always a bigger vision for us to look at. So please join me as I move into our affirmative prayer, spiritual mind treatment. I'm going to say this in the first person, so please join me as you choose. I'm so grateful to know that the vision of God is not just the outer vision. It is also the inner vision. And the inner vision of God is the inner vision of life in the fullest possible sight. The inner vision is love that emanates through the eyesight and through, as Dr. Maxine says, the eye of the heart. And in this understanding of this preciousness and this knowing of this vision of God, I'm so grateful that I'm a vehicle so that God sees through and by means of me, and that I am opened up to this inward insight of this presence of God that cultivates through and by means as peace and joy and harmony and wisdom and beauty and truth and bigger vision and even grander vision of life. And in this unification, this magnificent realization bursts through me as it bursts through tonight's service and through the sharing of the service on Monday, that God's divine vision of tonight has already laid its plan out so we can not only see it, we can feel it, we can touch it, we can be in it, and as it is in it through us, through all of our individuals that helped serve to get us here, our music, our audio visual, all of our friends, and we do have a lot of friends, as the song goes, are here. And the vision that is seen and heard through Dr. Maxine this evening. You see, this is the big picture. This is the insight that impacts our outer world. So thank you, Mother, Father, God, as I release this into the law, knowing that it is seen in this bigger picture, acted upon, and together we say, and so it is. Oh, yes, the affirmation. Thank you. Please join me as I say the affirmation. I enthusiastically embrace Spirit's great idea of life for myself, my loved ones, my community, and the world. Thank you.
Started with me, turned into greed. Profits at the loss of everything. God only knows I kept my eyes closed, blind to what the consequences bring. I'm starting to see lessons to be learned from history. Starting to see a window is opening to me. Clouded by fear, I couldn't hear. The voice of love was silent in my heart. I say farewell to the past, beginning at last to lift the veil that keeps us all apart. I'm starting to see new answers to this ancient mystery. I'm starting to see window is opening to me. Out of the darkness of my days, feeling my way out of the haze. Starting to see new answers to this ancient mystery. I'm starting to see a window is wide open. I've got my eyes wide open. And my heart's wide open to you.
Thank you, Ray. Yes, we're all starting to see. It makes me think of, I was like 18 and a half when I had my first child. He's lives in Kansas City now, and he's a lot bigger than he was then. And I remember sitting on the front porch when he was just a tiny little guy, just sitting out there with him, and a little girl in the neighborhood came up, and she said, "Can I see your baby?" I said, "Sure." So she came and looked at him, and she said, "Are his eyes open yet?" Like he was a puppy, you know? And that's what we're all doing, isn't it? We're all starting to see. Oh, okay. All right, we are getting a bigger picture. That's what we're focusing on now. And I want to share with you a quote from Albert Einstein, one of my favorite religious scientists. "The human being is part of the whole, called by us the universe, a part limited in time and space. He experiences himself, his thoughts and feelings, as something separate from the rest, a kind of optical delusion of consciousness. This delusion is a kind of prison for us, restricting us to our personal desires. Our task must be to free ourselves from this prison by widening our circle of compassion to embrace all living creatures and the whole of nature and its beauty." Well, do you know that today is United Nations Day? And do you realize that it was first chartered in San Francisco in 1945 at the War Memorial Auditorium, where I spent a lot of time going to a lot of great music? Their idea, their concept, their determination at that time was to maintain international peace and security, promote the well-being of the world's people, and encourage international cooperation. Are we there yet? It's still the goal. It is still the vision. It is still a possibility. In the 90s, when I was living in Northern California, the UN was having a meeting in San Francisco. Well, I was always a part of interfaith clergy groups. And the one at that time was part of a new idea that was forming called United Religions. And at the Episcopal Church, where we happened to be meeting the day that the representative came, I got to be one of the first signers on that, and I was very excited about it. But the most exciting thing was that in the 90s, when the UN was meeting in San Francisco, United Religions was meeting in Berkeley, of course, on my campus. It was so wonderful. I had, at that time, Steph and Chris, my original grandchildren, were quite small, but I took them to this great occasion, and they remember it still. Out in the quad, there were Native Americans. They're doing their wonderful ceremonies, and the kids were all a part of it. And then we went inside, and there were representatives for probably as many countries, maybe 50, that were meeting in San Francisco for the UN. And it was unforgettable that people from all over the world, in their native costumes, their native dress — they're certainly not costumes, this is not my costume, this is how I dress — they came from everywhere. And the most moving ritual to me of all of them was when all of these children, streams of children from different countries all over the world, carried small vessels of water from their most sacred rivers. And they walked down this long aisle to the front, where there was an enormous container, and each poured their sacred waters into this large container. and they were all mixed together. The sacredness from each country brought together. Now, I'm thinking that I love the United Nations and I love their purpose and I support them. And I also feel as though it just may be the interfaith communities that help to give it a little boost, to bring the heart to it, to bring the divine to it, whatever that means to others, so that we can have that greater vision and make it a reality. The vision of peace and security is one that we still all hold in our hearts. It's not disappeared. The vision is real. It is strong. Why is it real? Because it is a living truth. God is peace. God is truth. You and I are created from that one fabric. And that means every sentient being in the world is created from that same fabric. And so we have at the core of us the living spirit, the living waters, the reality of peace, the reality of the power of love rather than the love of power. That's the new vision we're working toward. It's not a new vision, but we're breathing new life into it. It's not disappeared, even though it's kind of hard to see it in the world today, isn't it? But it's still there. We must expand our consciousness by, as Emma Curtis Hopkins would say, by looking up. Look up. It's really easy to get mired in the stuff down below. We need to start looking up and realize there is a greater power than anything that appears to be negative, restrictive, or unlovely. A greater power at work within us that we are using to bring that vision still into reality. It's like Nehemiah. Remember in Nehemiah, he and other friends go to rebuild the wall in Jerusalem that has been destroyed by enemies. So Nehemiah goes with his workers and they are building the wall and they're up on the top, and some ne'er-do-wells came and they were meaning harm to Nehemiah and his friends. They said, "Oh, come on down, let's go into the village and spend some time together." Do you remember what Nehemiah responded? He said, if you know it, say it with me, "I am doing great work and I cannot go down." We're going to take a page from Nehemiah's book. And it's in chapter 6 that this story is. We are doing a great work and we cannot go down. You may have noticed our national elections are about 12 days away. Have you noticed anything about that? Reverend Mike and I already voted. We love doing that. We get the mail in, but we don't mail them in. We go to Westchester, and we go in, and we talk to the people, and we give them, and we get our receipts, and we put our, "I voted," and I trust you all have or will soon be voting as well. Well, it's just too easy to get entangled in divisiveness. There's too much of it out there. We don't want any of it in here, but have you noticed it kind of gets in sometimes if we're not standing guard at the portal of our mind? So we must insist on a greater picture of unity. We must insist on that. We must establish a bigger vision of unity and of peace. Come to the Interfaith Prayer Vigil on Sunday the 3rd. Come there and you'll find it's a place where we will feel united, where there will not be divisiveness. There will be no politics spoken. There will be prayer. There will be ritual. There will be song. There'll be an opportunity for us to come together and insist on unity, demand that wonderful sense of peace and oneness with one another. You see, an expanded awareness of the power of the presence, and that's what it takes, is what we need for a magnificent idea to be born. I can't do it by myself. You can't do it by yourself. We need to be together, and we need to open up to the magnificent power within us that knows what to do when we don't have a clue. And we often don't have a clue. Yes, it begins with each of us. Of course it does. You know, as spiritual leader, it is my responsibility, I feel, to begin with spirit. It's my responsibility to lead from the invisible to the visible. It's my responsibility to use the creative process as the divine process that it is, to bring a greater expression of love and peace and beauty and truth to the world. And to see beyond the appearances, that's my job. I need to see beyond the appearances and the situations and see the unerring truth that motivates us all and that is always the foundation of our very lives. But as a human being, I'm that too, I can become too involved in the appearance of divisiveness and conflict. And I must return to peace. I must return to oneness. I must return to truth. What are your personal battles? Anybody have any personal battles? I'm not asking you to tell us right now. There's probably not time for that. But we all have them. What are the conflicts that take place within ourselves where we know we must stand tall? We're doing a great work and we will not come down. What are the things that get us confused? What are the doubts, the uncertainties that pop up? Sometimes because we've been watching too much of the media, and sometimes just because we're humanly dealing with stuff. We know we are divine beings, and we still deal with human stuff. By the way, that's our spiritual cutting edge. That's how we grow. That's how we deepen our consciousness, by saying, oh, look at this. Okay, I will look at it for a while as I'm looking up to invite the divine resources to show me the way. Give me the direction. Change the confusion to clarity. Change the doubt or the anxiety or the fear to deep faith and a wonderful understanding that love underlies everything, that all the contents that we see going on in the world are held in a beautiful divine context of harmony. That's true. The more we remember that, the more we refocus our attention on that which is infinite and eternal, the less we will be affected by these little conflicts and battles that come up within us and between people as well. Emmett Fox's golden key is a wonderful thing to remember at these times, isn't it? Remember what he said? Forget about the problem and think about God. That's not a spiritual bypass. That happens to be exercising the truth, adhering to our principle, which says no matter what's going on out here, it's changing. Everything out here is intended to change. That's its nature. God never changes. Why don't we stick with what's real, with what's lasting? For God is the same yesterday, today, tomorrow, forever. All of these things out here are changing. Do not give them any power. Do not feed them any energy. They have enough negative energy of their own. The more we refuse the verdict and do not look at or become engaged in or conflicted by the stuff that we see, the more powerful and the more peaceful and the more effective we become in creating this new vision. Let's invite Spirit's wisdom, Spirit's compassion to show us the way, to lift us from a smaller consciousness to a brand new, powerful, possible vision. We have the freedom. You see, we've got freedom. You look in the back of our textbook written by Ernest Holmes, and I think freedom is one of of the most used words in the entire book. Freedom, freedom for, freedom of, freedom from, freedom to. Yes, we often think about being free from a smaller idea, but the more important part, isn't it, is to become free to utilize this intelligent, marvelous creative process to bring something more wonderful into our lives personally, into our loved ones' lives, into our neighborhoods, into our beloved community right here, and ultimately into the world itself. We have the freedom to dive deeply into this beautiful vision that we are creating together. So let's look at the smaller ideas that we have held. Held, by the way, you know that the Greek word for heaven is? Come on. There you go. Uranos, that which is forever and ever expanding. That's what heaven is. It is held in, that's held. So let's look at what might be some of these hellish ideas, things that we have held, beliefs that we have held that never were true. We didn't come in believing them, but somehow the world got it, you know, got our attention, and we began to believe some of these things that felt small and constricting, and we were held in. So, for instance, what do you believe you cannot do? That's kind of living in a state of hell. We're being held in by what we believe we can't do. What is the fear? If you have a fear, what is the fear that's keeping you hypnotized? And that's what fear does, isn't it? So we want to expand that. What's the opposite of fear? Faith. But also, what's the opposite of fear? Love. Let's enter into a deeper experience of faith and love and enter into the Uranos experience, the expanded consciousness of heaven ever, ever becoming more. That's what our vision is about. So let's raise our vision to the heavenly state. You do know, don't you, that with God all things are possible? Have you ever heard that? It happens to be true. And we're always with God. We can never be outside of God. That means that in any moment, at every instant, you and I have the possibility of remembering who we are, seeing it again, opening our eyes, understanding who we really are, and who everyone else is as well, and seeing everyone through the eyes of love, through the eyes of truth. Everything is possible, because the presence is right within us all the time. So I like casting the burden. When I get my knickers in a knot over anything and I begin to forget who I am and forget whose I am, I cast the burden onto the Spirit which is within and all around me. What a relief. What a relief. I prefer to live in grace. And I do live in grace when I remember the truth and stick to my vision. So are you willing to cast the burden? Turn it over to infinite wisdom. I think we all could benefit by doing that right now. And we can do it together, starting here, beginning now. Will you say with me, my vision of peace is powerful.
My vision of peace is powerful.
My awareness of oneness is dynamic. I am doing great work and I cannot come down. And so my beloveds, beginneth your lesson. Wow. Thanks, glad you liked it. Tell your friends. Now we're going to have our wonderful opportunity to celebrate our prosperity. And we celebrate our prosperity by remembering that God is the very source of our love, our health, our abundance, our creative expression. And right now we're experiencing the joy of celebrating the prosperity that flows to and through us all the time. I like to give my gift to the closest source of my spiritual food. Well, that happens to be this center. And so let's say together our prosperity affirmation. I choose to celebrate prosperity. Divine love blesses my gift. It is my acceptance of God as the source of my abundant supply. With joy and gratitude, I share my abundance with this center. In doing so, I am one with the law of circulation. My tithe goes forth to heal, to prosper, and to bless. It returns to me multiplied abundantly, and I am prospered, and so it is.
I am a light, I am a light, I am a light in this world. I am a light, I am a light, I am a light in this world. And I shine, so bright. And I shine, yes, I shine so bright. I am light, and I am light. I am light in this world. I am light, I am light. I am light in this world.
And so we bless and praise the flow of abundance that takes place within each and all of us. We give thanks to God being the source of all of our good, and so it is. Thank you. All right. Okay, this is a time that we get to take the all the practitioners who are here and ministers who are here, and let's come on down. We're going to have a few closing words, and then probably you're going to join us down here, you think? Should we do our circle, Ray? Okay, so in this consciousness of infinite possibility, we praise and bless the power within us all to make a positive difference in our lives, in our community, and in the world itself. God is completely in charge, and we are so grateful. We go forth from here this evening with a clearer understanding that there is God and nothing else. We give thanks and let it be so, and so it is. And now we'd have a closing song. Come on down here if you would like to. And the words will be right up there.
Nice, nice job.
Thank you. Anybody else gonna join us? Oh, good. Come on, Monet. Come on, Bob. Come on, Ray.
Okay, yes. Thanks.
Okay, we're getting to know this song, huh?
It's fun, isn't it?
It is fun.
May the grace of God bless me. Every woman in this land, stay strong and keep your faith alive. Whatever comes to meet us, no darkness won't defeat us. Stay strong and keep your faith alive. Some say the end has come, set our souls a-run. But I say, stay strong and keep your faith alive. Let's all come together, take care of each other. Stay strong and keep your faith alive. Raise your hand.
Raise your hand.
In the air.
In the air.
Stay strong and keep your faith alive. Take a stand.
Take a stand.
Say a prayer.
Say a prayer.
Stay strong and keep your faith alive. Hand in hand, side by side, with hearts open wide. Stay strong and keep your faith alive. And brothers, find a way with heaven here today. Stay strong and keep your faith alive. Raise your hands, yes, in the air. Stay strong and keep your faith alive. Take a stand and say a prayer.
Your prayer.
Stay strong and keep your faith alive. Well, times like these we need to remember what is real. Stay strong and keep your faith alive. United in our quest, just bring love and happiness. Stay strong, keep your faith alive. Raise your hand, yes, in the air. Stay strong and keep your faith alive. Take a stand and say a prayer. Stay strong, keep your faith alive. Raise your hand in the air. Stay strong and keep your faith alive. Take a stand and say a prayer. Stay strong and keep your faith
alive. And then we probably needed to keep doing it after that.